Hello, everyone. My name is Shamika Britton, real estate agent with Exit Realty Diversified, and I am your community real estate agent. All right, so welcome to my page. Today, I came to give you my Tip Tuesday. Earlier, you'll notice that I posted a post about my tip, and so today we're going to go a little bit more in detail about my tip of the day. So stay tuned for that. All right, so I wanted to show you something first, though. So if you look at the screen, I'm sharing with you my website. It's NashvilleFabLiving.com, and I would love for you to come check it out. I've put a lot of love and a lot of information on here that I would love for you to see. So on my website, just to give you a quick rundown of it, you're going to see communities. You're going to see some information about selling your home. You're going to see information about buying a home. You can search for properties directly from my website, and the homes available when you search through my website would be pulled directly from our MLS system, which is even more up to date than Zillow. So check it out. Also, I provide market stats, market reports, even some reports that's specific to Nashville. I also have a tab here that allows you to put your city in, and it gives you some great information about that community too. So I have a lot of great information under this report here. Also, you're going to see local events. Right now, we'll get that started back once we start like really having events. So I love to send that out to my subscribers every single week. So you can subscribe right here for that. Also, some lifestyle blogs, some real estate or some restaurants and real estate blogs. So lots of great content. If you need to reach me, you can schedule a phone consultation right here. It allows you to select your time. And then also get property updates. You click this, it's going to give you a landing page that's going to send me specifically what you're looking for in your property, and I'll be able to customize a search just for you. And that way you don't even have to do the search. I will have it sent right to you. All right, but today, my purpose was to do my Tip Tuesday, and the Tip Tuesday today is going to talk about mistakes that can delay your lender approval, all right? You can read this full blog by just going right under Real Estate Blogs and clicking the link. So I'm about to get that pulled up for us right now. All right, so it's going to be four mistakes that could delay your loan approval. All right, so you can read the full details straight from my website, but what I'm going to do right now is go over some slides that I created for us just to give you a kind of rundown of these four things to keep in mind. All right, let's make that bigger for you. All right, so the first thing we want to talk about here is the five mistakes, but let me get to the first one. I'm going to make myself a little bit bigger here. Alrighty, here we go. All right, so the first mistake that could delay that lender approval is leaving out details from your financial profile. You want to provide your lender with complete information. This is so important, even down to your name, ensuring that you're providing the full information to your lender. And sometimes, like you can see in cases where, you know, we don't use our regular name all the time. And so, you know, we don't give that, we give a different name. So just make sure that you're giving your lender full details regarding your financial profile, okay? The next thing we want to make sure to kind of talk about a little bit here is assuming that a pre-approval is equal to actual approval. All right, so when you contact me to talk about purchasing a home, one of the first things we talk about is our timeline. Right, the process we will take to get you to the closing table. One of the first things I recommend is getting a pre-approval from a lender. And I do provide a list of lenders. If you're needing that, I can definitely help you with providing a list of lenders that I recommend. But that's a pre-approval. So in that pre-approval process, your lender or the lender that you select will ask you for some information. They're going to ask you about your income and all those type of things. But you haven't yet provided them all of the proof, right? You haven't sent in all your documents at that time, and they're giving you an estimate of the loan approval based on information you provided and based on your credit. So keep in mind that to get the final approval, there are some processes that would need to take place in the meantime. Getting information to them would be one of those things. And then also making sure that from the day that you go into contract until closing, that you really monitor and be careful with your credit. You don't want to open up any new credit lines. You don't want to co-sign for anything. You want to make sure that you continue to keep it the same as it was when they initially went through your approval process. So that's going to be really important to make sure that you are, if you have any changes, you notify them as soon as possible to prevent that delay. So let's say if something happens with your job, you want to make sure you tell them as soon as possible, even if you get another job. It's all about that proper communication to avoid us from delaying that process. All right. So next, failing to provide every single piece of documentation needed. So they're going to ask you for quite a bit of information, right? You're going to have to get it to them either by fax, uploading the documents or something like that. So you have to go through some records and download some W-2s and pay stubs and all those kind of things, get them information to contact your employer, just several different steps, right? So you want to make sure that you do go through all the steps and then check back with your lender to make sure they got exactly what they need to make sure they can go ahead with your approval process. Again, we don't want to delay that process. All right. So just make sure you get all those details to them. And then lastly, we're going to talk about the knowing the mortgage rate to understand a little bit how the lock-in works, right? So you know that mortgage rates can fluctuate. They can change. The market can change. And so one of the things to keep in mind is when they do your pre-approval or when they're going through that process, it's based on the rates they have at that time. But that rate can change because it hasn't been locked in. You're unable to lock in your rate until you're under contract. And what that means is you found your home and you've put in an offer and your offer's been accepted. So that's when we're under a binding agreement. Once we enter that binding agreement, then we can go through the process of getting your rate locked. So until then, we have to keep in mind that it can change and fluctuate. And with that being said, it could delay your lending approval. It just depends on what's going on in the market. But again, it's all about communication for both ways. You communicate with your lender and your lender communicating back with you. So it's really important to pick a good lender that's going to be able to provide you with that information and keep that great communication going. All right. So again, my name is Shamika Britton. I'm so excited and I'm so thankful that you are here with me today. Stay tuned for our next Tip Tuesday. I will post a post about it with a little bit of information, and then I will also do a video. So again, this will be available on my YouTube channel, which is Shamika.Britton, or it may just be under Shamika Britton. You can Google me there and find me on YouTube. Also, look at Nashville Fab Living on Instagram and Nashville Fab Living on Facebook. And please go to my website, which is NashvilleFabLiving.com. Thank you so much. And here's my contact info if you need to get in touch with me. Feel free to email me. My email is here, and that's my mobile number that I use for work. So feel free to text that number or call. But you have a wonderful day. And again, thank you so much for watching. See you guys next Tuesday for our next Tip Tuesday. Have a blessed day. Bye.